already mentioned in my last video, we should start taking baby steps towards bringing big changes. So in this video, I will show you what are the baby steps that I have taken or what are the small changes that I have implemented in my life to reduce using plastic. And of course, these are the changes that you can implement in your life to reduce using plastic. So when we say reduce plastic, say no to plastic, you really don't have to spend a lot of time, lot of money, or you don't have to sacrifice a lot to bring these changes. These are very subtle or very small changes that you have to bring in your lifestyles. For example, instead of using shower gel, which comes in plastic bottles like this, you can start using soap bars that come with paper wraps or paper packets like this. And another way to reduce plastic is to carry a cloth bag or tote bag with you always. Whenever you go shopping, whenever you go outside, make sure you always carry a bag like this. By doing this, you can of course reduce bringing or buying more plastic. And as you can see, these are not really heavy, very easy to carry, very light. So make sure you always carry a bag like this. If you go for vegetable shopping, tell vendors you don't need a plastic bag for your vegetables. Ask them to put all the vegetables in your reusable bag. And yeah, it doesn't matter what kind of shopping you go for, make sure you always use your reusable bags instead of buying more paper and plastic bags. And trust me, once you start doing this, you will love it, because once you come back home from shopping, you will see very less waste or very less paper and plastic bags. So you don't have to worry about throwing them out or throwing them away. So yeah, start doing it, you will see the difference. And another way to reduce using plastic in kitchen is to stop using cling wrap and start using these reusable silicone lids. As you can see, they come in different sizes, so you can use them to cover leftover food or to cover different size vessels and fruits as well. If you are not sure how to use these silicone lids, I'll make another video to show how these can be used. But yeah, make sure you're trying to avoid using cling wrap in kitchen. And another way to reduce plastic is to carry your own coffee mug. I know this is not easy, but yeah, make sure you're carrying your own coffee mug whenever it's possible. If you are a coffee person, you obviously drink a lot of coffee. If you're traveling or if you're outside, you go with takeaways. And takeaways come with, obviously, with a plastic or paper cup. So if you want to avoid or reduce using plastic there, make sure you're carrying your own reusable coffee mug. I'm not really a coffee person, but when I'm traveling, I feel like drinking coffee. At the same time, I feel bad to use paper or plastic cups. So yeah, I try to carry my coffee mug whenever I'm traveling. So that's all for today. As I already mentioned, these are very small and subtle changes that you can bring in your lifestyles. So start practicing these and see the difference. In my next video, we will see some other different ways to reuse or to reduce waste and to reduce plastic.